I'm going to show you how to create your own smart mirrors. So starting off, what I got here is the Wilderus smart mirror frame. So it's basically got a frame with a two-way glass and the backing behind it. And what you're also going to need is a Fire tablet or any other Android tablet. We're not going to be using a Raspberry Pi in this case because there's very little space behind this mirror, and it probably just makes sense to have a nice little display on one corner of your screen. So we're going to use this app, this one with the Mango Display app, controlled by the Mango Mirror iOS app that's on the iPhone. So let's get started. So first thing we got to do is we want to flip this thing over. I'm going to try and keep the edges clean. Flip it over like that. Okay, and we got to get rid of all these screws. There's a bunch of screws in here, so I'm just going to use one of these. Just unscrew it. This is a pretty good starter for a smart mirror. They do have a cloud version Wilderus software, but I much rather prefer the Mango Display one. It's a lot easier to put together, and the Android tablets are cheaper than a Raspberry Pi with a screen. You don't have to worry about all the connections and things like that. And there's a lot of space. The space here is going to be perfect for it. So I got these screws off. I'm just going to put these things under. So you got to figure out which way you're going to hang this one. So this way is the top. So I'm going to make sure I want it to show up when I'm looking at the mirror. I want it to show up somewhere on my right side. So I'm going to put it right there. The cool thing about this mirror, though, is that you can decide how you want to hang it. So you can hang it in portrait mode, which is what I'm going to be doing. But you can also hang it in landscape mode. And you can decide where you want to put your display for your smart mirror. So basically, take this off, keep it to the side. Okay, and it comes with a nice black backing here, which is helpful because you want to make sure that the light doesn't go through. Okay, so now all we got to do is, it's very simple now with using the Mango Display app. You don't have to worry about the Raspberry Pi screen or anything like that. So I'm going to just open this up, and like I said, I'm going to put it on that side. So I just want to make sure I got my Fire tablet set up. I'm going to go to the App Store and install the Mango Mirror app, or the Mango Display app. So I'm going to just go there. Mango Display, so I'm going to download that. And I'm going to come around this way just to show you how I set it up. So once you've got this one downloaded, you open this up, okay? And then you've got to also open up your iOS app, and you're pretty much ready to get it all set up. So I'm going to go to Add. I'm going to choose Mango Display Android app. So this one is the Mango Mirror iOS app, which basically controls everything that you want to see on this one. So once you have it set up on your mirror, you can continue to add widgets and resize and choose the screens and things like that from here without actually having access to the device. Okay, so I'm going to set up new display. That's what it sees there. I'm going to call it my smart mirror. White. Okay, and then the display device code automatically shows up, the one that's there. If not, just type it in. Hit next, and you're done. So you can have, for example, the clock, which is what I'm going to have in here. Okay, and you can also add in any number of other widgets that you want, right? So I'm gonna add in maybe my steps. Okay, there you go, there's my steps. And maybe on the second one, I'm gonna add in some news maybe. Let's do BBC News. And on the third one, I'm gonna put in, for now anyway, gonna put in the weather. Today's weather, the 24-hour and the 5-day forecast. I'm gonna save that. And you have a lot of options, so you can actually customize this, so you can figure out, say, how you actually wanna set these widgets. You can also choose the number of seconds or minutes that you want each screen to last for. So I think that's pretty good for a start. Let's get started. So now that you got everything started, you're good with everything there. And also, before you get started, make sure your Amazon Fire has Alexa hands-free enabled. I'm gonna come back this way. So like I said, I'm choosing to do it somewhere about here, right? Which is good enough. And what I'm gonna do is actually, rather than stick it on the glass itself, I am going to put it onto this backing. So let me just put it up here. This is probably roughly where I want it. All I'm gonna do is just use tape, stick it on, and that should be good enough. You can stick it right on the glass as well. That's an option too. I also like to cover up the camera option. I don't much care for Amazon's privacy policy sometimes. Okay, and now make sure you got it set up in the way that you want your power cord to go through, because we're going to just take our power cord through the bottom. We're just going to do that. Just get a little bit of tape there. And make sure you're using black tape, because you want to make sure that black will not show through the mirror itself. If you use any other colored tape, you're going to be able to see it from the front. So make sure that you are using some sort of black electrical tape would be fine. These are pretty small. Okay, that's pretty much it. Now I've got this thing done. All I'm gonna do is put it back. And there is a setting on the Fire tablet where you can actually make sure that it does not go to sleep if you've got it plugged in. So make sure you have that setting enabled on the tablet. And on the Mango Mirror app, you can actually set display schedules. So you can set it to come on, you know, during your weekday schedule, like for example, from 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. in the morning and 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. at night. You can do all those settings in there so it's not on all the time, okay? So now we're gonna basically put this back, okay, exactly the way it was. So I'm just gonna make sure that this thing goes there. So you'll notice it is a little bit tight, even with the tablet. So you gotta be careful when we do this one. Make sure that that's right. Get this one back in here, okay? Once that's good, we wanna screw it in, and we wanna make sure we don't screw it in too tight, especially towards that end, all right? So we're gonna get this back in here, and we're gonna start to put the screws back. Okay, so once you got those things lined up, get a couple of them lined up, and then when you do this, make sure this is not very tight, because you got your tablet right here. So you just want to make sure it closes, and that's good enough. Okay, so when you get here, you just want to get just enough. It's nice and flimsy, so you should be able to just get it in there. That's it. It's good enough for those corners. Okay. You see a little bit of a bulge, but that's fine. It's all good. This is going to go at the back. Okay, and then you get the rest in. It's ready to be plugged in. And let's check it out. How's it going to look? Let's see. And there you go. That's how it looks after it's all set up. Everywhere else, it basically looks like a mirror. And with the Mango display and the Mango Mirror app, you can choose whatever it is you want. And provided you still have some gaps between the board, you can still use Alexa as intended. If not, you can just make some more perforations to allow for the sound to both come in and out. And that's it. That's how easy it is to set up your own smart mirror.